Push P. Yeah, Push P, turn me up.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to my new video. Almost done right here with the book. This book is called 99 Bottles of Beer in JavaScript. They have this book, I believe, in JavaScript, PHP, and Ruby. Yeah, I think so. I'm not too sure about the PHP one. I know they have it in Ruby, though. All right, so right now it's just been a lot of reading, a lot of strategic type stuff. So let's see. The word context has been used a number of times. This is a new chapter, a new section. Still chapter 9. Section on seeking context independence. Last chapter of the book. The word context has been used a number of times under the assumption that its technical meaning would be clear based on well context. You've probably already developed an idea about its meaning, but a discussion of the term is in order. An object's context is its surrounding environment, or the interrelated conditions under which it can exist. Objects that require large, convoluted context are picky about their surroundings. They know too much about the outside world. They require particular things to be true about their environment, which limits their use to very specific situations. Objects are, this has to do with tight coupling. So that's when your objects are like very, very specific. And like it says right here, it limits the use of that object to a very specific situation. Objects are more usable when they know less. Objects loosely coupled. That's the key word, loosely coupled. Objects that expect little of their surroundings can be more easily applied to novel situations and so provide greater utility. The most useful are those that are entirely independent of context. They have no expectation about and make no demands upon the external world. As far as context goes, ignorance truly is bliss. This section explores these ideas by examining the bottles class and its remaining tests with an eye towards reducing their context. Oh, finally, some code after like 10 pages. All right, so before looking at bottles tests, pause and refresh your memory of the class itself. All right, so just kind of showing the class, you know, what it is. Let me just make sure everything's cool. Go to my bottles class. All right, so we have the constructor, we have the song, versus everything was, this class was huge, this bottles class, but everything was separated. So now we have the bottle number class. We have just a bunch of them. All right, so everything does look good though. The code above is the end result of iteratively extracting bits that needed to vary. The outcome is a class that has nothing to do with the 99 bottle song. It retains vestiges of its formal context. The name bottles, the default bottle verse, the magic number 99. But someone unfamiliar with the code's history would not recognize this class as that song. I'm assuming we're going to change the name of the class. Bottles is no longer the right name. Yeah. This is not a bottles at all. It's something completely different. they've been talking about it for like a few chapters now. They're like, oh, we need to change the name of the bottles. They just haven't done it yet. We're doing, I think, I don't know, last chapter, we were working on the tests. We made a few new tests for bottlers, because the tests that we had before, they were only bottles. And so to do new tests, I had to export. That's why I was down here when I came into this page. I was, yeah, like all the way down here. I had to export bottlers and then import that bottlers class so that I can use it over here for testing. I wasn't sure at first. I was like, do I create a new bottlers? Because this right here is bottles.test.js. Like, do I create a new one? Like bottlers.test, you know? I just don't know how to create one. I've worked with tests. I just never created one. Alright, so pretty much. Let's see. The name bottles diminishes this class, making it appear to be less than it is. Remnants of the circumstances from which it came continue to bind it to a specific context, even though it is now more generally useful. True. Now the song can be used for anything, not just bottles. So, yeah. Even the name. Let's say we didn't use the name bottles here. Let's say we used it in, like, bottle verse. Like, even that class. It may or may not need to be different. Who knows? We may change that one as well. Let's see. Only by reading now. Get a find out. All right, so the name bottles diminishes this class, making it appear less than it is. Remnants of the circumstances from which it came continue to bind it to a specific context, even though it is now more generally useful. The class has become more abstract, but its very name will prevent programmers from recognizing its broader utility. Take a fresh look at this code and describe what it does. Let's see, where's the code? You might be tempted to say it's a song. That is correct. Yep, a song. But we already have a song method. Can you name a class and a method the same thing? I've never tried that. But within the bottles, we have song. That is correct, but you can do better. It's a particular kind of song and is distinguished by the down to. On line 11, a down to song? That could be a name for it. On line 11 above, it's reasonable to assume that a song with numbered verses will count up. This song is a bit unexpected in that it starts at the top and counts down. This is a countdown song. True. It is a countdown song. And it'd be also dope if we can do not just 99 to 0, but like any number pretty much. The next section remains bottles to countdown song. Renames. I just don't know. I read the wrong words sometimes. A lot of times. But before moving on, sit back for a minute and think about how dissimilar a class named countdown song feels from a class named bottles. You know, weird story. Last night I had a dream that I was in college. I was in school, and I was at a regular school because the college that I used to go to, it's just, you know, it's just a regular college. It looks like a high school pretty much. But this dream that I was in, it was like one of those fancy, it's like those classes that you see in the movies where it's like it looks like a podium. Like, you're like, how do you say it? Like, when you walk in, like, the teacher's like down there, and then you're like, the seats are like, you know, like a university type thing. And so I was in one of those classes. The teacher was a lady. I think it was an English class. Or it might have been like a French class. I don't, like, I was probably learning a language. I don't know exactly what it is. We were going over the syllabus. It was quick. It was probably like, I was probably in that scene for like 20 minutes in that dream scene or whatever. But anyways, I don't know. It doesn't relate to what I'm talking about, but it's just a thought. The next section remains bottles to count down song, but before moving on, sit back for a minute and think about how dissimilar a class name countdown song feels from a class name bottles. Bottles is parochial and useful in one specific case. Countdown song is generic and useful in many cases. Countdown song. It could be any song, and it counts down. Counts down. For a class name bottles, a bottle verse default and the hard coded 99 seem entirely reasonable. In a class name countdown song, these relics of a prior context are just plain annoying. Yeah, that's what I was saying. Like, if we're gonna change the name from bottles to countdown song, then we're gonna have to change the other classes as well. It can't be bottle verse, bottle number, song number, maybe. Like, it's just gonna have to change completely. A lot of renaming, pretty much. That's all it is. And then what else? Annoying, and you will be motivated to remove them. Bottles constricts possibilities. Countdown song expands them. Yeah. And I'm gonna end it right there. Thank you guys for watching. Y'all have a good ass day. Peace out.
Even if you are not ready for the day, it cannot always be night.